A Maine State Police say a Thomason insurance agent has been arrested on a charge of promotion of prostitution. Police arrested Mark Strong and searched his home at insurance agency offices in Thomaston. State Police have been helping the Kennebunk Police for several months with the investigation. Police say a Thomason insurance agent was running background checks on potential clients for prostitutes in Kennebunk. Mark Strong is facing one count of promotion of prostitution. Strong was back at work at his Thomason insurance agency today, but would not talk about his recent arrest. News 8's Paul Merrill joins us now live from Kennebunk, where the investigation is centered, and he has the very latest. Paul?
Well, Tracy, State Police arrested Strong yesterday. This court affidavit details his alleged connection to a woman who runs this Zumba studio here in Kennebunk. Now, she is not facing any charges, but in this document, police say she was having sex for money and posting videos of the acts online. Kennebunk police say Strong's arrest is part of an investigation that started last September based on complaints regarding this Zumba studio.
People were just saying that they were noticing some suspicious activity. Lots of people coming and going, in particular single men showing up and staying for short periods of time. And
court documents identify the owner of the Pure Vita Zumba studio as a woman named Alexis Wright. In those documents, police allege that Wright was performing sex acts for money and, unbeknownst to her clients, videotaping the encounters. This past Valentine's Day, police searched the York Street studio along with nearby office space on High Street and Wright's Loop Road home in Wells. Police say those searches recovered evidence of prostitution, including ledgers and video recordings. The affidavit says bank, postal, and telephone records connect Wright to Strong. The owner of this building tells us Strong is the one who signed Wright's lease. Wright is not facing any criminal charges. Police say their investigation isn't over yet. Now, we have made multiple attempts today to contact Alexis Wright, but we have yet to hear back from her. Live in Kennebunk, Paul Merrill, News 8.
A Portland lawyer wants to know why his client is still the only person being charged in a prostitution case that could involve a slew of other people. Attorney Dan Lilly says that his client, Mark Strong, shouldn't be facing a promotion of prostitution charge if no one's being charged as a prostitute. Court documents detail Strong's alleged connection to a woman who runs a Zumba studio in Kennebunk. News 8's Paul Merrill joins us now live with the latest. Paul?
Tracy, the original affidavit filed in this case talks about a detailed list of clients and sexual acts. Kennebunk police say that list of names is still sealed and not even the defense has access to it. Mark Strong's attorney says he's willing to call every single person on that list to the witness stand if that's what it takes to prove his client's innocence.
Nothing has been forthcoming, and I'm trying to figure out why.
Portland defense attorney Dan Lilly is frustrated because he says prosecutors aren't giving him any access to the evidence being used to build the case against his client, Mark Strong of Thomaston.
My client's charged with promotion of prostitution, but there's no prostitute. At least no one's ever been charged. And there's nobody even charged with engaging a prostitute.
Police arrested the 56-year-old insurance agent early last month. A court document says Strong has ties to Alexis Wright, a woman who runs this Kennebunk Zumba studio. An affidavit filed by Kennebunk police says Wright had sex for money and videotaped many of the acts, sometimes without her clients knowing. Wright is not charged with a crime. Her lawyer had no comment today. The court document says Strong, who is a private investigator, ran background checks on Wright's potential clients. Lilly says the only connection Strong had to Wright was co-signing the lease for her Zumba studio.
If that were true, that every bank that lent money to somebody who ultimately went into a criminal enterprise would be guilty, and I don't think that's the case.
Lilly says he will file a motion to dismiss the charges, an effort to pressure prosecutors into giving him access to the evidence, something he says should have been done weeks ago.
I'm not against, sure, I'm on the outside looking in, and that's not a comfortable feeling when your client is the only one charged with a crime.
Neither the Kennebunk Police nor the York County District Attorney's Office would respond to Lilly's comments today, citing their still ongoing investigation. Mark Strong's next court date is scheduled for October 4th. Live in the studio, Paul Merrill, News 8.
It's a story News 8 first broke on our website, WMTW.com. Earlier this evening, a York County grand jury has indicted the owner of a Kennebunk Zumba studio on more than 100 charges in connection with a prostitution case. 29-year-old Alexis Wright is facing charges including engaging in prostitution, promoting prostitution, conspiracy, and tax evasion. In court papers, police accuse Ryan of having sex for money and recording the acts, sometimes without her clients knowing. The grand jury also indicted Thomaston businessman Mark Strong in connection with the case. He is facing 59 counts, including promotion of prostitution and violation of privacy. Until today, Strong was the only person charged in the investigation. On new details tonight about a Zumba instructor police say was running a prostitution business out of her Kennebunk studio. Alexis Wright is facing a 106-count indictment in York County, and she's charged with crimes that extend beyond prostitution. News 8's Paul Merrill joins us now live with the latest. Paul.
Well, Tracy, the indictment also accuses Wright of tax evasion and lying on her application to receive benefits like food stamps. Kennebunk police say they expect to start issuing summonses to Wright's alleged clients as soon as next week.
The Pura Vida Zumba studio is gone. The owner of this Kennebunk building tells us he kicked Alexis Wright out after she fell behind on the rent. The saga involving the 29-year-old Wells resident has been developing for several months now. Yesterday, a York County grand jury indicted her on 106 counts. Nearly half of those charges are for prostitution. Also indicted, 57-year-old Mark Strong. The 59-count indictment against the Thomaston insurance agent accuses him of promoting prostitution and conspiring with Wright to record her encounters with her clients. Part of the indictment against Wright says she set up a recording camera and/or an internet connection in a surreptitious manner in a private place to record individuals without their knowledge and/or allow her co-conspirator to view the video. Court documents also say Wright lied about her income so she could keep receiving public assistance such as food stamps. She told DHHS that she had about $200 in the bank and her Zumba studio was going out of business. Investigators estimate she was actually pulling in about $150,000 a year. This case has Kennebunk residents buzzing.
I think there's a lot of people talking and probably some people that are sweating bullets about that list that may or may not come out.
Kennebunk police say they'll start issuing summonses next week for people they refer to as clients of Wright. Folks here don't think the ordeal will permanently hurt the town's reputation.
I don't think it's something that's indicative of Kennebunk. It's a nice town and it's a nice place to live, and I'm quite surprised.
News 8 learned today that neither Alexis Wright nor Mark Strong has ever been convicted of a crime before. Strong has pleaded not guilty to one count of promoting prostitution. His attorney is scoffing at yesterday's indictment. Wright's attorney declined to comment for this story. Live in the studio, Paul Merrill, News 8.
A judge is refusing to keep the names of alleged clients confidential in the case of a former Zumba instructor charged with prostitution in Kennebunk. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The two people at the center of the case, Alexis Wright and Mark Strong Sr., appeared in a Cumberland County courtroom today. News 8's Paul Merrill was there and he joins us now live from Portland with the latest. Paul.
Tracy, the judge refused to sign a confidentiality order that would have kept the names of the alleged clients in this case secret until the case goes to trial. Also today in court, the prosecution says that one of the computers it seized from Mark Strong's home may have some other illegal material on it. In court together for the first time today, the Zumba instructor and insurance agent who police say ran a prostitution business out of this Kennebunk storefront. Mark Strong Sr. indicted on 59 counts, including promoting prostitution.
Not guilty.
Alexis Wright indicted on 109 counts, including engaging in prostitution.
Not guilty.
Prosecutors hauled boxes of evidence into court today. Strong's lawyer, Dan Lilly, says York County and state attorneys have been dragging their feet when it comes to sharing their evidence.
They've taken a case, a small case, they've blown it into to a nightmare, but they're not prepared to go forward on it. They don't have the resources they claim. They don't seem to have the abilities.
Prosecutors say they've seized more than 100 hours of video.
It's so much that it couldn't just be readily copied onto a DVD or CD and provided to Mr. Lilly. It's that much information.
I would ask.
The judge sided with the defense, calling the prosecution's behavior unacceptable and scheduled a hearing about the evidence for next Thursday. Prosecutors also said today that an analysis of a computer seized from Strong shows it may contain child pornography. However, no one is charged with anything related to child porn in this case. Dan Lilly says there's no truth to this new claim.
There's no child pornography in this case. They told me that personally. They emailed it to me and they put it in a pleading in court. And now they seem to be saying they want to go back and see what's going on. As I said before, they don't know what the hell they're doing.
We know that police have begun the process of issuing summonses to the alleged clients in this case, although as of right now, nothing has been filed in court, so none of those names are being made public right now. The judge today said that the prosecution needs to pick up the pace on this case, and she said that she'd like to start talking by the end of the month about when to schedule the date for this trial to begin. Live in Portland tonight, Paul Merrill, News 8.
Good evening, and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. More on those stories in just a moment. But first, Kennebunk police have released the names of 21 people charged with engaging in prostitution. This afternoon, a judge shot down the latest request to block the release of names of the alleged clients connected to the Kennebunk prostitution case. News 8's Paul Merrill is following the story and joins us now live with more on the latest developments. Paul?
Well, Tracy, Kennebunk police just released the first group of names about 20 minutes ago. We are in the process of researching these names based on some quick internet searching. The alleged clients appear to come from all parts of New England and all walks of life, including businessmen and lawyers. Police charged these people in connection with their investigation into a now defunct Kennebunk Zumba studio. Investigators say Alexis Wright was using the business as a front to engage in prostitution and secretly record her encounters with her clients. Thomaston insurance agent Mark Strong, Senior, has also been indicted as part of this case. Both Wright and Strong have pleaded not guilty. Now, lawyers for the alleged clients had tried to block the release of their identities. A judge ruled this afternoon that Kennebunk police can release the names, but because these men may be victims of invasion of privacy, the judge ruled that police should not release their addresses. These 21 men are scheduled to appear in Biddeford District Court on December 5th. Lawyers have said Wright's client list contains as many as 150 names. Live in the studio, Paul Merrill, News 8.
A more breaking news tonight. Kennebunk police have just released a more detailed list of the men being charged with engaging a prostitute as part of the ongoing investigation into a now defunct Zumba studio. News 8's Paul Merrill is following the late breaking developments and joins us now live with more. Paul.
Tracy, police sent us this updated list just about 15 minutes ago. Earlier today, they said they would be releasing the men's middle initials and suffixes, such as junior or senior, in an effort to avoid confusion. Well, this afternoon, a judge ruled that police could also release the men's addresses. This new information shows that this first batch of Alexis Wright's alleged clients range in age from 34 to 65. 19 of the 21 live here in Maine. One man is from New Hampshire. Another one is from Boston. All are scheduled to be in Biddeford District Court on December 5th. The earliest Kennebunk police will be releasing more names will be October 26th, which is 1 week from this Friday. Live in the studio, Paul Merrill, News 8.
All right, thank you, Paul. And Kennebunk police say they can only release the names of people as their investigation continues. Meanwhile, today we are getting a first look inside the former Zumba studio. News 8's Jim Keithley is live in Kennebunk with more on that. Jim.
Well, Tracy, this is the back door to that Zumba studio on Main Street in Kennebunk. Now, the property manager actually runs his own business one door over and says that he has seen men come and go from this door at all times of the day. And tonight, for the first time, a look inside. 2,500 square feet with brightly painted walls, a reception area, a hallway, and two bathrooms. There's no basement and no back room. According to property manager B. Wynn, Wynn said that when Alexis Wright rented this space for her Zumba studio, there were large curtains covering the front windows. Police say they investigated what may be going on here after people called to say that men would show up one by one and stay for short periods of time. In the documents, police alleged that Wright was performing sex acts for money and unbeknownst to her clients, videotaping the encounters. Down the street at the Kennebunk police station, three detectives are working the case full time, one from Kennebunk PD and two on loan from the Maine State Police. And now, some of the names of the alleged Johns are being released. Police are publicly releasing the names of those charged in small batches because of the extensive investigative work required for this case. The townspeople calling it a salacious scandal, many of them hoping it will go away soon. Are you ready for this thing to be over?
Long time ago. You know, it's just, you know, it's kind of a strange situation. It happened, and time to move on.
Lawyers in the case say there could be as many as 150 suspects. A lieutenant says the cases are being processed one by one and not to expect the next batch of names to be released until the next police blotter comes out on October 26th. Police say it could be months before they are able to get through all of the names and decide who should be charged. And we're back live in Space Felice. There you see it. The property manager says his brother actually owns this building, and, you know, they'd like to actually re-rent this. They said a few people have come forward calling for getting some information, but they said so far no takers. Live in Kennebunk, Jim Keithley, News 8.
The Thomaston businessman facing dozens of charges in the Kennebunk prostitution case is speaking out, talking about his relationship with Alexis Wright and saying he was being targeted by Kennebunk police. In a statement to ABC News, Mark Strong said, quote, I met Ms. Wright several years ago online and we developed a personal relationship. I'm a businessman and I loaned her money to start a legitimate Zumba dance studio. In addition to my insurance agency, I'm a licensed private investigator. At one point, I conducted an investigation on Ms. Wright's behalf because of concerns she had that the Kennebunk Police Department was harassing her. It is my belief that the Kennebunk Police Department publicly charged me as retaliation against me for my investigation of their department. In response, Kennebunk Police said Mr. Strong will answer to his indicted charges accordingly via the criminal justice court process. Any comments regarding his or Attorney Lilly's allegations will not be issued by this agency. Meanwhile, the fallout from the release of the list of suspected clients in the case continues. A family member of a former city councilor who also served as mayor and ran a successful business is speaking out tonight. The son of Jim Sewell says he and his family have been left to pick up the pieces from the alleged prostitution scandal. News 8's Jim Keithley spoke with him and joins us from the studio with more on the story. Jim.
Well, Megan, Adam Sewell says that his family is crushed. He says his father, who was a well-known politician and businessman in South Portland, called his three kids and apologized for the scandal that was about to hit, and now he's asking for privacy. When you, you know, again, got that call from your father, were you disappointed?
Yes, I was disappointed.
And what went through your mind?
It was shock.
Adam Sewell is the eldest son of Jim Sewell, a well-known businessman who served on the South Portland City Council from 1988 to 1992 and again from 2006 to 2009. He served as mayor twice. This is video of him being interviewed in July 2009. When Kennebunk police released the first list of alleged Johns in the prostitution case, naming Alexis Wright and her business partner Mark Strong, they incorrectly gave Jim Sewell's former address in South Portland. Adam Sewell said his father retired and moved to Florida 2 years ago, and he bought the house from his dad. The news of his father being on the list has brought sadness, disappointment, and embarrassment when the names and the addresses were released by police.
It affected my wife and I. We had people knocking at our doors. We've had phone calls, constant phone calls the last 2 days. So it's been very tough on my wife and I.
Kennebunk police issued an address correction today, listing an address in Fort Myers, Florida, as the address of Jim Sewell charged in this case. This is a billing change form filed in the South Portland City Assessor's Office back in November 2010. It shows his change of address from South Portland to the same Florida address named in the police report. Adam Sewell says he and his family are left to pick up the pieces of this scandal, and he is hoping this won't affect the business his father owned and he now runs.
I hope that people can move on maybe not forgive, but forget in a way.
Adam Sewell ended by saying his story is an example of how this scandal is affecting innocent people. He said, obviously, it's not fair to our family members. We placed a phone call to Jim Sewell at that address listed in Florida. He has not returned our call. Live from the studio, Jim Keithley, News 8.
And in the meantime, Kennebunk's town manager has a message. Barry Tibbett said while the town has no doubt suffered a black eye from the worldwide publicity surrounding the prostitution case, it does not represent the town's standards and reputation. He honestly believes the town will survive the scandal. In fact, he says, if you look around, you'll see little evidence that anything is wrong.
There are things that life goes on and the town is moving on. It's a resilient community. We've dealt with struggles before. We'll certainly work through this. And, you know, we certainly want to be as compassionate as we can. But I think people are looking at it saying, you know, the name's out. It's acknowledged. Clearly it happened in Kennebunk. We're sorry it happened here. It wasn't something we invited. But let's move on.
Tibbetts went on to say he's not afraid the negative publicity will have any significant impact on the town's all-important tourism industry. A judge has already accepted the first guilty pleas in connection to the Kennebunk prostitution case. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. According to court documents uncovered by News 8 that were filed in York County Superior Court, four men entered guilty pleas last week and paid fines that were issued by a York County judge. Each man pleaded guilty to one count of engaging a prostitute. News 8's Paul Merrill is live at the Alfred Court with more. Paul.
Well, Tracy, pleading guilty and paying fines last week may have kept these men's names out of the police blotter, but it did not keep their names out of this court filing. The four men range in age from 31 to 56. Three of them live in the Portland area. One has an Arizona address. Each one paid a fine between $400 and $800, and their cases are now closed. Now, for weeks now, the Kennebunk police have been releasing the names of alleged Johns every other Friday in their police blotter. Those men are being charged in connection to what police say was a prostitution business being run by former Zumba instructor Alexis Wright. She and Thomaston businessman Mark Strong have been indicted on dozens of counts related to this case, and they have pleaded not guilty to all of those charges. A judge has also just ruled that Wright and Strong will have separate trials. Strong's trial scheduled to begin in January. Wright's will start in May. An attorney representing one of the men who pleaded guilty last week says he arranged the guilty plea with prosecutors to try and keep his client's name out of the media. He tells News 8 tonight that he's outraged that his attempt to spare his client's family from public shame has now failed. We wanted to speak with the assistant district attorney who's prosecuting this case to ask about how these developments came about. She refused to give us any details today. We also learned through court filings today that at least two of the Johns who had already been summoned by police have requested jury trials, and one of those accused men is former Kennebunk High School hockey coach Donald Hill. Live in Alfred tonight, Paul Merrill, News 8.